playing Game of Thrones first episode, and make sure you subscribe to noob_gaming215. He won't be doing videos for 2 days. Well, he'll be back on Saturday. So he did a video today, I think. He won't be doing a video tomorrow, and he'll probably do a video on Sunday. Anyways, let me just stop blabbering. Leave just a few more blabbering, or whatever. Leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and enjoy the video. Now I'll stop blabbering. Let's get into this. Alright, so let's check out the Northern Mist will never forget. I am the sword in the darkness. I am the watcher on the wall. Dracarys. Do the dead frighten you? When you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die. Jeez. They can live in my new world or die in their old one. Okay then. Now, let's do episode 1. And go leave a thumbs up to popular MMOs, Super Girly Gamer, which is Pat and Jen. Thousands of years, House Forces have been in the darkest reaches of the Wolf's Wood. They have harvested the rare iron trees. Now the North has been ripped apart from and seek to claim the fort is run back. Well, dang it.
You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Lord Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
Okay, let's pick it up.
Make sure it's spotless this time. Lord Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it. Go on, it's only blood.
Oh, God.
Now that is a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself someday.
You? I'll never have a sword like that. I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest, we are just a squire.
I had Andy, you know.
Andy what?
Capturing him.
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk he barely made it out of his tent. Next, I tell us he caught Tyrion, too.
You think he's lying?
Nor never lets the truth stand in the way of a good story.
You captured the Kingslayer.
Ah! Well, I don't have to deny.
And round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What did I tell you?
Brought him to his knees.
Lord Forrester.
But not before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face.
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
I'm questioning Norrin's story. This goes more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get me a Liege Lord some wine.
Go on.
your job.
Right, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it. Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries. His honor is beyond reproach. House Tully is forever in his debt.
They've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield.
Fetch your gun. The night we celebrate.
Okay, he just smiles and they insult him.
To Robb Stark, the king in the north!
The king in the north!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard! The gods are favorites!
Onward to Casterly Rock!
Get to the Lannisters!
Winter is coming!
Let's hope they wait till this bloody war's over.
Garrett.
Yes, my lord?
Secrets!
To keep an eye out for Roderick. As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become. On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
There's also a question. What's to be done with you? It's been on my mind for a while. Something must be done.
With me, my lord?
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever. How shall I reward your loyalty? What can I offer you?
Let me fight for you, my lord.
You've more than proven your ability on the battlefield. No man would question that. There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. Now you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this
between. Just like Minecraft story mode are until dawn.
I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
Squire, fetch us more wine.
Can you give me a hand? Come on, make it up to you. Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you,
so
I outrank you. You should help me.
It's my luck to end up with Norrin in the use of the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for once. He's a drunk, liar, and an arrogant prick.
You'd better watch your tongue, Owen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norrin.
Wait, what? The curse in this game? Awesome.
That's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop,
I'm rather hitting things or the curse.
Greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms. I suppose this beats pig farming. But not by much.
Who doesn't love bacon?
Pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life. All in wine around the fucking wedding. What a waste of fucking time.
Give it time. You'll get there.
Easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were Castellan and House Forrester, I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is, that's nothing to do with it. How much further?
It's right over there.
The twin stronghold of House Frey. The Red Wedding.
Take your time.
You lot have drunk your share. Good thing, Lord Walders. In a generous mood.
Fuck off, friends.
nice night for the wedding.
Alright, what are you thinking of?
Not after he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Gary.
What's wrong? What's gone into you? You're acting rather odd. You've had too much wine.
We have enough wine.
Then take the fucking flagon already.
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Owen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush. But what about... What the hell was that about? Slow down, would you? What's the rush?
Run!
Killed myself. Great job. Great job. How do you work this game? First of all, I need to know how to work this game. No. I'm coming.
Ready, boys. Whoa. Shoot that one.
Come on. No! How do you freaking hit them? What button do you press? I press like every button. You guys must feel good watching me failing. Okay, he ran that way without me. Like a coward.
Ready, boys! Whoa!
Shoot that one! Okay, I need to know how to work this. Guys, tell me what button to press. I need to know what button to press. Do I press square?
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
Oh god! Oh, I know how to work it now. I had to move the left stick. Okay. That took me a while. Run!
Ready, boys! Whoa!
Shoot that one! Okay, yeah, you better. Wait, what? No! What? What? That's impossible! Wait, gosh. Wait. Alright. Yeah, come on. Guys, give me the power. Give me the power to do this. My power is darkness.
Ready, boys?
Whoa. Shoot that one.
Shoot that one.
Oh.
What?
Come on. Why isn't it moving? Is it the freaking left stick or the right stick? Oh, guys, give me darkness!
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
Get wrecked. Whoa. Whoa. That's fine. Wait. Woo. Go faster. Oh yeah, this is like Minecraft 3 mode. Aw, I don't want the shield anymore. Oh! Come on, you got this? No! Don't call her name. Don't call her name.
Garrett, find Roderick. Speak up, Garrett. Did you see him or not?
The friends. They slaughtered him, my lord.
Find a weapon, quickly.
Oh, God. Ah! Oh, thank you, sir. No!
What a freak. You fucking traitor. Go, my lord, while there's still time.
No!
Seven heads.
You're wounded, my lord.
I've suffered worse. Guard this with your life. Return it to him.
Okay, then. Now I gotta get used to using the right stick.
I won't leave you, my lord.
And you will.
My lord,
by the gods, you will obey me. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him. Do you understand?
You must swear.
Tell only your uncle Duncan. The future of the house may depend on it.
Tell only the Castellan.
Hey, it's those foresters.
You must do this for your house. Go!
Kill the freaking foresters!
With Lothar, I'm afraid.
No! That's chapter one. That is of chapter one, because chapter one was short. Please don't say this is a puzzle game. I don't like puzzle games. I don't like puzzles. Okay, there's like 500 places I probably have to go through. Is this where I am right now? Okay, I'll just skip through that. Oh, I can't. Game of Thrones. It's Minecraft story mode. Episode 1, Iron from Ice. Okay then. Forest Lands, the Kingdom Road. Yep, I think Minecraft story mode people made this tattletale. Are you gonna kill the piggy and eat him? Are you gonna kill the piggy and eat him? That's a good idea. No, you're not gonna do that. Okay then. Blood?
Blood.
Okay, I wish my character wasn't British.
Fresh.
Wish he was English, not British. Not used to British people. A dead pig. Why don't you eat him alive? What? Campers. Let's go kill him. Actually, no.
That's Father's car.
Whose car now? Never mind, that sounds really painful.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
I said move on. Unless you want to get fed to the fucking pigs. I'm going to kill you.
Let's do this.
Is that so? You can try if you like, and then we'll feed you to the pigs.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton Land now, boy.
Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North. I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that. No. I'll have that sword, boy.
It's gonna be mine. Oh, yeah, they...
Fuck you.
No!
Finish this fucking pig farmer.
Pathetic. I'm not a pig farmer. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
God.
You're a pig farmer, aren't you?
Woo! OMG. OMG. Hello, new viewer. Nice to meet you. Oh god, I have to finish it myself. I'll be taking my sword back. Oh! He stepped on my leg! Savage! Oh! Dang! Doink!
Mercy! Please! I beg of you! I have a family! They'll never survive without me! I have no quarrel with you! I was only following orders.
Kill him!
Please!
I'm savage!
Lord Whitefield will see you hang for this! That much I promise!
Yeah, you get who's the little boy now. I don't care if you have a family. You try to kill my family.
Gary,
no, they beat him with
you
your father.
Your sister. She hid it.
You have a sister? Wait.
I tried to stop them.
No! No! Are you dead? Are you dead? No. No, father.
I'll kill the man who did this.
I mean, you already killed once on some. But you just need to kill one more. Just freaking 1 minute more. Alright, so, where's your sister, or should I say my sister, since I'm playing as you? Uh-oh.
It's Garrett! Get the Castellan! Tell him his nephew survived! Garrett!
They were already dead.
Bring the maester. Meet us in the Great Hall. Quickly.
Two Whitehill soldiers?
And a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what? My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Mister.
Wait, what happened to his sister?
Blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg.
Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you. But the White Elves won't see it that way.
They attacked me. I had no choice but to defend myself.
Of course. And we can't let the White Elves just walk all over us.
These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Ew.
These are dark days, I fear. To lose the lord of the house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal.
Oh, that's so disgusting.
Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late
that's
Lord
so
Foss
disgusting.
And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
What do we do now?
The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now.
Wait, what's my name?
This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved his life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, the squire, not his son, Roderick.
Not the butler couldn't handle himself. He's as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
Roderick had already fallen. There was nothing they could do.
Although I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg. Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
I go over here. What do I do? Where do I go? Maybe I'll become that lord one day. Maybe.
The Iron Grove.
My question is, where do I get out of this place from?
Good thing you've done, bringing that back to House Forrester. By right, that belongs to Lord Ethan now. Does your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Why did the White House hate the Forresters?
I think it's safe to say the feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember. I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of someones, and then, well, here we are.
The White Hills want Forrester Ironwood.
They'd take it all if we'd let them, especially now with the Boltons in power. And proceed to clear-cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left, just as they've done before.
Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
White Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned, advising the late Lord Forrester, advising Ethan, his third-born son, as challenged.
Who is Ethan? I want to meet this Ethan guy, kill him, and I want to become the lord.
The future of this house rests in his hands, which is rather frightening when you think about it.
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roderick and his men. Although given the circumstances of your circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose.
Is that my uncle?
But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
He is, but I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Any time will tell. Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrity. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garen, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family... I'm sorry.
Nita.
Off to bed now. Hurry on.
Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know. Whatever you can recall.
He was a hero, my lady. The bravest man on the battlefield by far.
Yet he was unable to save his own son.
You were with Roderick, no?
I'm sure it was chaos and confusion.
But if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
I'm sorry, my lady. Nothing could be done to save him.
He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially our children. But I was told... I was told you were the last to see your husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything you said?
Any last words before he passed, if you can remember?
He asked me to return this to House Forrester. He said this is where it belongs, with his family.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, that bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much, I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
Not now. When?
We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you ask? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett suffered enough already. You asked too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard. It was his family they killed.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So, what's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of his house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this. I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
I'd have done the same, as any man would.
Fuck the Boltons. One of their men killed my family.
Aye. You'll say it was justice. They'll say it was murder. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take. Which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay? Duncan, the boy has suffered enough.
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the war? The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
Uncle, you can't send me to the wall. I'm not a criminal.
There'd be nothing we could do to protect you. To stay would bring destruction upon us all. I know that's not what you want. I know it's difficult to understand. But you must think of the house.
Still not right.
No, it's not. But it's what's best.
That settles it then.
You can have my horse.
and I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you. Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But now, I have House Forrester to consider first. I know you're not a criminal, but Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the House ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
He promoted me at the Twins. We were to ride in the van to Casterly Rock, and I at Roderick's side, but...
It was well-deserved, Gavin. You worked hard and served your lord with honour.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What?
It's important. Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said... The North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
What is the North Grove?
Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett. I need to know the truth.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone in the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help. I am from ice.
I am from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll be strong.
I know you will.
Be safe. Hey! That's Ethan.
Boy. I couldn't find him. Could you? He hides too well. And if he was smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game. Ryan, look who we found.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
Stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you would...
Gone. I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mary was here. And Asher. And and Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing, and
can she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want
well,
her
promises?
To die. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
I don't know what he did to get sent away like that.
He let me ride one of his pigs once. It was fun.
He won't get hurt.
He got hurt by those Whitehill men. No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about him, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight.
What?
He calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know, but I know it's not good. Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. Then, and everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training. He never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like that.
I promise, I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
We'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
Don't be it with that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once. But Ethan will be a good lord. A proper lord.
You have to understand. Being lord is a great responsibility. I can't just fool around.
Thank you for that, Roderick.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. On your feet.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were you, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
I might remind you, Sir Roiland, I'm the new Lord of House Forrester, not you.
Of course, my lord.
It's okay. You should go. It's what must be done.
Fine. Let's be done with it.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in the lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here.
Business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is. Was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you said you were the Lord. Now prove it.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
Tell him to go away.
I'll throw him out the gate myself if you'd like.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Foresters finally get their due. Hold your tongue, you coward. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Fetch Lord Whitehill some bread and salt. It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Ah, and we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished! Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the King's peace, as his lordship here said. When your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the Lord of this house.
He was defending his family as any man would. But your men murdered them all.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their time. Where's the fucking captain who killed my men?
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
We haven't seen him. He was never here.
You little liar. I will find him. By the gods, you better hope I do, because if I don't, I'm holding you responsible. And you answer for what he's done.
I'm not leaving. Until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. This is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be Lord of this house. Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
Do as you like, Lord Whitehill.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once. Your sister can help us. Although just a hand,
this is a long episode. Or should I say these episodes are long?
King may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay, if it's presented to her as it should be.
Graydon, playing as a woman, female.
Ethan made this for me.
Who's this? Is that the girl?
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena. Father, much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can. Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos. Wonders made by man, by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
I'm sorry, I'm really quiet, guys. When I'm really quiet like this, I'm interested in the game.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Okay. Go open the door.
One moment.
Oh. Sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you're right. If you don't mind my asking. You seem rather upset.
I'm fine, thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here in a minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong. But it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the royal steps, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but it was definitely an argument. I heard them arguing about House Forrester.
House Forrester?
I thought you'd like to know. Forgive me if I was mistaken. I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. Most people don't tend to notice a cold boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, Lord.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss. From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
Of course, Mary. But you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the royal sect. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear. See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us. You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Good luck.
You can do this.
Ah, Lady Marjorie, aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion, Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Your Grace.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Yes, Your Grace. To the one true king.
The one true king. Yes, she didn't say which. The girl is clever.
She only meant... I don't care what she meant. I care what she said. I won't stand for impertinence from a girl of the North.
If you would give her the chance to explain...
Perhaps she can explain why the Foresters have been loyal Bannerman to House Stark for centuries. A house of traitors.
They are noble, not traitors, Your Grace.
Noble? Perhaps once, for a northern house. But now, they're merely dead. Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned, but now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Our talent is unrivaled, Your Grace. Forrester Ironwood is highly sought after in the Seven Kingdoms.
So I'm told. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask the Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house they claim to be yours.
I won't dishonor myself, Your Grace.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
Raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Rhaenyra Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flip through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the North, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I must choose Margaery, Your Grace. I serve at her pleasure.
Clearly your handmaiden does not have her priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
You were brave to declare your loyalty to Lady Margaery. No doubt she was pleased, but Cersei, she will not soon forget what you said. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I wasn't trying to please her.
I think that was clear to anyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
I wouldn't want to anger Cersei.
And you'd be wise not to. But I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion, but it's a risk I cannot afford.
I admire your discretion. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join you for dinner tonight. 3 beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival.
Thank you for the advice, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah, what?
It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Which I doubt is Dornish for wife. He is quite handsome and quite passionate, from what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Margaery can make the right introductions. Who knows, we might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Margaery well, which is more than you can say for his mother. I'd marry anyone if it helped my family.
Right, of course.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well? Sarah?
We're sorry, my lady. We were just having fun.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was rather disappointed by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
Once you are queen, the lords and ladies will do their best to please you.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, But I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her. Go on. Ask.
I received a letter from my family. I fear my family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. But if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown, Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
That is no small request, especially now. Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady! King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa. Please, Lady Margaery, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Don't let them believe you. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within a week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity you didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forester Lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise.
I want to be like that, like my father.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone, and it took years, if not decades, to earn. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Why did you do it?
Because I've no wish to die!
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right. Speak truth.
I've a family to feed. There are not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it. Calm yourself.
The time for calm passed with the late Lord Forester. Now there's only chaos.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their law will not permit it.
We can send him to the war.
I will decide.
Send him to the war. Take his fingers, thief!
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. Will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord, my family depends on me.
House tends to its people. See, this man has paid his family's fed.
Lord Ethan, you are truly a merciful and noble lord.
My lord, this man is a criminal. A brazen thief.
He still serves House Forrester and deserves our protection.
He's a rat in our grain stores.
My lord, we must speak about our gold reserves. Soon.
My lord, I thank you for the mercy you've shown me. I will never forget my debt to you and to this house.
One sec, guys. I'm gonna have to end this here, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a thumbs up. Subscribe to NoobSlayer_Gaming215. Subscribe. Bye, and have a great night. Bye.